I am Sangeeta from English Department Shift 2, and the presentation which I am going to give is drama. And let me start with the first slide, which is entitled as drama. Here, the church had the drama under its complete control. Okay, the beginnings of the drama, the one who started the drama were from the church. You see, the performances were given in the sacred buildings, even in the church premises. And the actors in the drama were the priests. Okay, the priests were the actors, and Latin, the language Latin was employed in the beginning. Okay, they were speaking Latin on the stage for the drama. English was not used at first. And they called the drama the mystery or miracle play and morality or interludes. Okay, the events connected with the two chief anniversaries in the Christian calendar, Easter and Christmas. Okay, the dramas were enacted during these celebrations, especially according to the Christian calendar, who were celebrating Easter as well as Christmas. And the dialogues for the dramas were taken from the Latin of the Vulgate Bible. Okay, yes. Then, the scenes were staged first in churches, then in streets, then in churchyards, later on platforms along the street and on the village green, etc. Okay, it started from the platform of the church, later it is moved into churchyard, then platforms, streets and even village green. Okay, everything is actually used for the enactment of drama. Okay, there was not any proper stage like as we had during this Elizabethan time called this Globe Theatre or whatever. And the next one is, the subject matter of the drama was extended, covering the episodes of the four Gospels, a few from the Old Testament and a number of saints' legends. Okay, so therefore, the subjects were taken from the Gospels, from the Old Testament, as well as from the lives of the saints. And by 14th century, you find writers like Chester, York and Coventry organized the materials for this drama. Okay, they have partially, individually, prepared and organized a material exclusively for drama. And those contains like Passion Play, the depiction of Christ's sufferings and death on the cross, still enacted Bavarian village of Obermergo. And the mystery plays, there are two divisions in the drama you find. And the first one is actually mystery plays. It is from the Latin ministerium, meaning occupation or meaning craft. Miracle plays or saints plays, they are distinguished as two different forms, although the terms are often used interchangeably or among the earliest formally developed plays in medieval Europe. Medieval mystery plays focused on the representation of Bible stories in churches as tablets with accompanying antiphonal song. A miracle play presents a real or fictitious account of the life, miracles or martyrdom of a saint. So therefore, these miracle plays often, they have got the subject mostly from the lives of the saints, sometimes the stories from the Bible. Okay. And also the martyrdom of the saint. Okay, and the next one is, yes, we are talking about this genre called drama. The genre evolved from liturgical offices developed during the 10th and 11th centuries to enhance calendar festivals. As we have seen in the first slide, the Christian calendar, they were celebrating this Easter as well as Christmas. By the 13th century, they had become vernacularized and filled with unecclesiastical elements. Unecclesiastical means something that is not very religious. Okay, unecclesiastical refers to Bible and religion. They had been divorced from church services and were performed at public festivals. You see that slowly the drama is actually divorcing the church, its services, everything, and it is moving away from it. Okay, and they started to perform even in the public festivals. Almost all surviving miracle plays concern either the Virgin Mary or Saint Nicholas, the 4th century Bishop of Myra in Asia Minor. The next slide is almost all about this Mary plays. So far we have seen this the Virgin Mary or Saint Nicholas, the fourth century bishop of Myra in Asia Minor. Now, the Mary place, we are going to see elaborately about what this Mary place is all about. And this Mary place consistently involve her in the role of Deus Ex Machina, coming to the aid of all who invoke her, be they worthy or wanton. She saves, for example, a priest who has sold his soul to the devil. Okay, as we can find, yes, that these Mary plays actually will help the characters to overcome the evil. Okay, however, they were tempted by the evil. A woman falsely accused of murdering her own child and a pregnant abbess. Typical of these is a play called St. John the Hairy. This is the best example for this Mary play. At the outset, the title character seduces and murders a princess. Upon capture, he is proclaimed a saint by an infant. He confesses his crime, whereupon God and Mary appear. I am Sangeeta from English Department Shift 2, and the presentation which I am going to give is drama. And let me start with the first slide, which is entitled as drama. Here, the church had the drama under its complete control. Okay, the beginnings of the drama, the one who started the drama were from the church. You see, the performances were given in the sacred buildings, even in the church premises. And the actors in the drama were the priests. Okay, the priests were the actors. And Latin, the language Latin was employed in the beginning. Okay, they were speaking Latin on the stage for the drama. English was not used at first. And they called the drama the mystery or miracle play and morality or interludes. Okay, the events connected with the two chief anniversaries in the Christian calendar, Easter and Christmas. Okay, the dramas were enacted during these celebrations, especially according to the Christian calendar, who were celebrating Easter as well as Christmas. And the dialogues for the dramas were taken from the Latin of the Vulgate Bible. Okay, yes. Then, the scenes were staged first in churches, then in streets, then in churchyards, later on platforms along the street and on the village green, etc. Okay, it started from the platform of the church, later it is moved into churchyard, then platforms, streets and even village green. Okay, everything is actually used for the enactment of drama. Okay, there was not any proper stage like as we had during this Elizabethan time called this Globe Theatre or whatever. And the next one is, the subject matter of the drama was extended, covering the episodes of the four Gospels, a few from the Old Testament and a number of saints' legends. Okay, so therefore, the subjects were taken from the Gospels, from the Old Testament, as well as from the lives of the saints. And by 14th century, you find Chester, writers like Chester, York and Coventry organized the materials for this drama. Okay, they have partially, individually, prepared and organized a material exclusively for drama. And those contains like Passion Play, the depiction of Christ's sufferings and death on the cross, still enacted Bavarian village of Obermergo. And the mystery plays, there are two divisions in the drama you find. And the first one is actually mystery plays. It is from the Latin ministerium, meaning occupation or meaning craft. Miracle plays or saints plays, they are distinguished as two different forms, although the terms are often used interchangeably or among the earliest formally developed plays in medieval Europe. Medieval mystery plays focused on the representation of Bible stories in churches as tablets with accompanying antiphonal song. A miracle play presents a real or fictitious account of the life, miracles or martyrdom of a saint. So therefore, these miracle plays often they have got the subject mostly from the lives of the saints, sometimes the stories from the Bible. Okay. And also the martyrdom of the saint. Okay, and the next one is, yes, we are talking about this genre called drama. The genre evolved from liturgical offices developed during the 10th and 11th centuries to enhance calendar festivals. As we have seen in the first slide, the Christian calendar, they were celebrating this Easter as well as Christmas. By the 13th century, they had become vernacularized and filled with unecclesiastical elements. Unecclesiastical means something that is not very religious. Okay, unecclesiastical refers to Bible and religion. They had been divorced from church services and were performed at public festivals. You see that slowly the drama is actually divorcing the church, its services, everything, and it is moving away from it. Okay, and they started to perform even in the public festivals. Almost all surviving miracle plays concern either the Virgin Mary or Saint Nicholas, the 4th century Bishop of Myra in Asia Minor. The next slide is almost all about this Mary place. So far we have seen this the Virgin Mary or Saint Nicholas, the 4th century Bishop of Myra in Asia Minor. Now the Mary place, we are going to see elaborately about what this Mary place is all about. And this Mary place consistently involved her in the role of Deus Ex Machina, coming to the aid of all who invoke her, be they worthy or wanton. She saves, for example, a priest who has sold his soul to the devil. Okay, as we can find, that these Mary plays actually will help the characters to overcome the evil. Okay, however, they were tempted by the evil. A woman falsely accused of murdering her own child and a pregnant abbess. Typical of these is a play called St. John the Hairy. This is the best example for this Mary play. At the outset, the title character seduces and murders a princess. Upon capture, he is proclaimed a saint by an infant. He confesses his crime, whereupon God and Mary appear. I am Sangeeta from English Department Shift 2, and the presentation which I am going to give is drama. And let me start with the first slide, which is entitled as drama. Here, the church had the drama under its complete control. Okay, the beginnings of the drama, the one who started the drama were from the church. You see, the performances were given in the sacred buildings, even in the church premises. And the actors in the drama were the priests. Okay, the priests were the actors. And Latin was employed in the beginning. Okay, they were speaking Latin on the stage for the drama. English was not used at first. And they called the drama the mystery or miracle play and morality or interludes. Okay, the events connected with the two chief anniversaries in the Christian calendar, Easter and Christmas. Okay, the dramas were enacted during these celebrations, especially according to the Christian calendar, who were celebrating Easter as well as Christmas. And the dialogues for the dramas were taken from the Latin of the Vulgate Bible. Okay, yes. Then the scenes were staged first in churches, then in streets, then in churchyards, later on platforms along the street and on the village green, etc. Okay, it started from the platform of the church, later it is moved into churchyard, then platforms, streets and even village green. Okay, everything is actually used for the enactment of drama. Okay, there was not any proper stage like as we had during this Elizabethan time called this Globe Theatre or whatever. And the next one is, the subject matter of the drama was extended, covering the episodes of the four Gospels, a few from the Old Testament and a number of saints' legends. Okay, so therefore the subjects were taken from the Gospels, from the Old Testament as well as from the lives of the saints. And by 14th century, you find writers like Chester, York and Coventry organized the materials for this drama. Okay, they have prepared and organized a material exclusively for drama. And those contains like Passion Play, the depiction of Christ's sufferings and death on the cross, still enacted Bavarian village of Obermergo. And the mystery plays, there are two divisions in the drama you find. And the first one is actually mystery plays. It is from the Latin ministerium, meaning occupation or meaning craft. Miracle plays or saints plays, they are distinguished as two different forms, although the terms are often used interchangeably or among the earliest formally developed plays in medieval Europe. Medieval mystery plays focused on the representation of Bible stories in churches as tablets with accompanying antiphonal song. A miracle play presents a real or fictitious account of the life, miracles or martyrdom of a saint. So therefore, these miracle plays often, they have got the subject mostly from the lives of the saints, sometimes the stories from the Bible, okay, and also the martyrdom of the saint, okay. And the next one is, yes, we are talking about this genre called drama. The genre evolved from liturgical offices developed during the 10th and 11th centuries to enhance calendar festivals. As we have seen in the first slide, the Christian calendar, they were celebrating this Easter as well as Christmas. By the 13th century, they had become vernacularized and filled with unecclesiastical elements. Unecclesiastical means something that is not very religious. Okay, unecclesiastical refers to Bible and religion. They had been divorced from church services and were performed at public festivals. You see that slowly the drama is actually divorcing the church, its services, everything, and it is moving away from it. Okay, and they started to perform even in the public festivals. Almost all surviving miracle plays concern either the Virgin Mary or Saint Nicholas, the 4th century Bishop of Myra in Asia Minor. The next slide is almost all about this Mary plays. So far we have seen this the Virgin Mary or Saint Nicholas, the 4th century Bishop of Myra in Asia Minor. Now the Mary plays, we are going to see elaborately about what this Mary plays is all about. And this Mary plays consistently involve her in the role of Deus Ex Machina, coming to the aid of all who invoke her, be they worthy or wanton. She saves, for example, a priest who has sold his soul to the devil. Okay, as we can find, that these Mary plays actually will help the characters to overcome the evil. Okay, however, they were tempted by the evil. A woman falsely accused of murdering her own child and a pregnant abbess. Typical of these is a play called St. John the Hairy. This is the best example for this Mary play. At the outset, the title character seduces and murders a princess. Upon capture, he is proclaimed a saint by an infant. He confesses his crime, whereupon God and Mary appear. I am Sangeeta from English Department Shift 2, and the presentation which I am going to give is drama. And let me start with the first slide, which is entitled as drama. Here, the church had the drama under its complete control. Okay, the beginnings of the drama, the one who started the drama were from the church. You see, the performances were given in the sacred buildings, even in the church premises. And the actors in the drama were the priests. Okay, the priests were the actors. And Latin was employed in the beginning. Okay, they were speaking Latin on the stage for the drama. English was not used at first. And they called the drama the mystery or miracle play and morality or interludes. Okay, the events connected with the two chief anniversaries in the Christian calendar, Easter and Christmas. Okay, the dramas were enacted during these celebrations, especially according to the Christian calendar, who were celebrating Easter as well as Christmas. And the dialogues for the dramas were taken from the Latin of the Vulgate Bible. Okay, yes. Then the scenes were staged first in churches, then in streets, then in churchyards, later on platforms along the street and on the village green, etc. Okay, it started from the platform of the church, later it is moved into churchyard, then platforms, streets and even village green. Okay, everything is actually used for the enactment of drama. Okay, there was not any proper stage like as we had during this Elizabethan time called this Globe Theatre or whatever. And the next one is, the subject matter of the drama was extended, covering the episodes of the four Gospels, a few from the Old Testament, and a number of saints legends. Okay, so therefore, the subjects were taken from the Gospels, from the Old Testament, as well as from the lives of the saints. And by 14th century, you find Chester, writers like Chester, York, and Coventry organized the materials for this drama. Okay, they have partially, individually, prepared and organized a material exclusively for drama. And those contains like Passion Play, the depiction of Christ's sufferings and death on the cross, still enacted Bavarian village of Obermergo. And the mystery plays, there are two divisions in the drama you find. And the first one is actually mystery plays. It is from the Latin ministerium, meaning occupation or meaning craft. Miracle plays or saints plays, they are distinguished as two different forms, although the terms are often used interchangeably or among the earliest formally developed plays in medieval Europe. Medieval mystery plays focused on the representation of Bible stories in churches as tablets with accompanying antiphonal song. A miracle play presents a real or fictitious account of the life, miracles or martyrdom of a saint. So therefore, these miracle plays, often they have got the subject mostly from the lives of the saints, sometimes the stories from the Bible, okay, and also the martyrdom of the saint, okay. And the next one is, yes, we are talking about this genre called drama. The genre evolved from liturgical offices developed during the 10th and 11th centuries to enhance calendar festivals. As we have seen in the first slide, the Christian calendar, they were celebrating this Easter as well as Christmas. By the 13th century, they had become vernacularized and filled with unecclesiastical elements. Unecclesiastical means something that is not very religious. Okay, unecclesiastical refers to Bible and religion. They had been divorced from church services and were performed at public festivals. You see that slowly the drama is actually divorcing the church, its services, everything, and it is moving away from it. Okay, and they started to perform even in the public festivals. Almost all surviving miracle plays concern either the Virgin Mary or Saint Nicholas, the 4th century Bishop of Myra in Asia Minor. The next slide is almost all about this Mary plays. So far we have seen this the Virgin Mary or Saint Nicholas, the 4th century Bishop of Myra in Asia Minor. Now the Mary plays, we are going to see elaborately about what this Mary plays is all about. And this Mary plays consistently involve her in the role of Deus Ex Machina, coming to the aid of all who invoke her, be they worthy or wanton. She saves, for example, a priest who has sold his soul to the devil. Okay, as we can find, that these Mary plays actually will help the characters to overcome the evil. Okay, however, they were tempted by the evil. A woman falsely accused of murdering her own child and a pregnant abbess. Typical of these is a play called St. John the Hairy. This is the best example for this Mary play. At the outset, the title character seduces and murders a princess. Upon capture, he is proclaimed a saint by an infant. He confesses his crime, whereupon God and Mary appear. I am Sangeeta from English Department Shift 2, and the presentation which I am going to give is drama. And let me start with the first slide, which is entitled as drama. Here, the church had the drama under its complete control. Okay, the beginnings of the drama, the one who started the drama were from the church. You see, the performances were given in the sacred buildings, even in the church premises. And the actors in the drama were the priests. Okay, the priests were the actors. And Latin, the language Latin was employed in the beginning. Okay, they were speaking Latin on the stage for the drama. English was not used at first. And They called the drama the mystery or miracle play and morality or interludes. Okay, the events connected with the two chief anniversaries in the Christian calendar, Easter and Christmas. Okay, the dramas were enacted during these celebrations, especially according to the Christian calendar, who were celebrating Easter as well as Christmas. And the dialogues for the dramas were taken from the Latin of the Vulgate Bible. Okay, yes. Then, the scenes were staged first in churches, then in streets, then in churchyards, later on platforms along the street and on the village green, etc. Okay, it started from the platform of the church, later it is moved into churchyard, then platforms, streets and even village green. Okay, everything is actually used for the enactment of drama. Okay, there was not any proper stage like as we had during this Elizabethan time called this Globe Theatre or whatever. And the next one is, the subject matter of the drama was extended, covering the episodes of the four Gospels, a few from the Old Testament and a number of saints' legends. Okay, so therefore the subjects were taken from the Gospels, from the Old Testament as well as from the lives of the saints. And by 14th century you find writers like Chester, York and Coventry organized the materials for this drama. Okay, they have prepared and organized a material exclusively for drama. And those contains like passion play, the depiction of Christ's sufferings and death on the cross, still enacted Bavarian village of Obermergo. And the mystery plays, there are two divisions in the drama you find. And the first one is actually mystery plays. It is from the Latin ministerium, meaning occupation or meaning craft. Miracle plays or saints plays, they are distinguished as two different forms, although the terms are often used interchangeably or among the earliest formally developed plays in medieval Europe. Medieval mystery plays focused on the representation of Bible stories in churches as tablets with accompanying antiphonal song. A miracle play presents a real or fictitious account of the life, miracles or martyrdom of a saint. So therefore, these miracle plays often they have got the subject mostly from the lives of the saints, sometimes the stories from the Bible. Okay. And also the martyrdom of the saint. Okay, and the next one is, yes, we are talking about this genre called drama. The genre evolved from liturgical offices developed during the 10th and 11th centuries to enhance calendar festivals. As we have seen in the first slide, the Christian calendar, they were celebrating this Easter as well as Christmas. By the 13th century, they had become vernacularized and filled with unecclesiastical elements. Unecclesiastical means something that is not very religious. Okay, unecclesiastical refers to Bible and religion. They had been divorced from church services and were performed at public festivals. You see that slowly the drama is actually divorcing the church, its services, everything, and it is moving away from it. Okay, and they started to perform even in the public festivals. Almost all surviving miracle plays concern either the Virgin Mary or Saint Nicholas, the 4th century Bishop of Myra in Asia Minor. The next slide is almost all about this Mary plays. So far we have seen this the Virgin Mary or Saint Nicholas, the 4th century Bishop of Myra in Asia Minor. Now, the Mary plays, we are going to see elaborately about what this Mary plays is all about. And this Mary plays consistently involve her in the role of Deus Ex Machina, coming to the aid of all who invoke her, be they worthy or wanton. She saves, for example, a priest who has sold his soul to the devil. Okay, as we can find, that these Mary plays actually will help the characters to overcome the evil. Okay, however they were tempted by the evil. A woman falsely accused of murdering her own child and a pregnant abbess. Typical of these is a play called St. John the Hairy. This is the best example for this Mary play. At the outset, the title character seduces and murders a princess. Upon capture, he is proclaimed a saint by an infant. He confesses his crime, whereupon God and Mary appear.